Welcome back to another lightsaber form video. Now that we have covered form 1 and form 2, we move on to form 3, also known as Soresu. And just as a quick reminder, these videos are brief explainers on these forms, noting their origin, the basic defensive strategies, the pros and cons, etc., and a notable practitioner of each. So, diving into Soresu, this form was known as the Resilience Form, or the Way of the Mynock. This form was initially developed because the use of blasters throughout the galaxy had increased to such a point that the previous two forms were no longer sufficient forms of defense. One of the central techniques of Soresu was the lightsaber's blade being able to deflect bolts right back at the attackers with extensive practice. And this was considered a major breakthrough in lightsaber combat due to what was called blaster supremacy during that time. Now, beyond that pretty important aspect of Soresu, practitioners also maintained an intense calm, often referred to as the Eye of the Storm, while being able to withstand multiple opponents around them. You are the calm while your enemies rage around you. And of course, we can see this demonstrated in Obi-Wan's duel with General Grievous, and in some instances, during the duel against Anakin Skywalker on Mustafar. Now, while this form was initially developed to deal with blaster fire, Soresu evolved over time and turned into a form where you can defend yourself from attacks of almost any nature. And because of this fact that Soresu emphasized strategic attack combined with being mindful of the moment-to-moment unfolding of a battle, this form became a viable option of extensive study to the Jedi Order because of its ability to be effective in basically every situation. As shown in the intro of this video, a true master of Form 3 is considered invincible. Now, why is this called the Resilience Form? Well, it's really simple. With this form, you could outlast your opponent, with the caveat that you have committed all of your mental resources to focus on your defenses as well as every single move your enemy makes. This allows for quick exploitation of weak spots in your enemy. As your opponent becomes exhausted, these openings present themselves more often. And luckily, similar to Form 2, a practitioner of Form 3 doesn't need to expend all that much energy due to the form's economical motions. As I stated, this form requires a calmness in the practitioner, an almost complete detachment to one's emotions while dueling. So the mind and motions of the body remained precise, while the opponent grew more frustrated and tired. In a way, Soresu embodies the philosophy that there is no emotion, only peace. Soresu is arguably the most Jedi form out of all the lightsaber forms known to exist. In regards to Soresu's weaknesses, we look no further than the fact that there is almost no emphasis on offensive strategies. Now, we have seen some basic offensive strategies performed in the film, such as Obi-Wan against Vader in A New Hope. You know, Obi-Wan clearly strikes first, while also attempting to find an opening on Vader. And also, Obi-Wan decapitates an ungodly amount of droids in the Clone Wars. But it has also been suggested that there is no need for an offensive strategy by virtue of the form itself. And in a sense, I'd say that's true. If you are cool, calm, and collected while maintaining your focus and energy while dueling, eventually the opening to strike will present itself. Now, there aren't any offensive attack sequences to speak of regarding Form 3, however, we do know a few basic stances. The opening stance of Form 3 is pretty iconic. You would have the saber in a backhand position facing your opponent from the side on, while your hand and blade were extended towards your opponent. The Jedi Path book itself does present a deviation on this opening stance where you are facing your enemy head on, with the saber pointed almost completely downwards across your chest. But I'd say either stance is correct, and then another stance for Form 3 is the brace stance, which would have you holding your lightsaber on your dominant side, with a two-handed grip and the lightsaber extending straight up, while your legs opposite of your dominant side was extended forwards. And then there's an alt to this form, which is to have the blade in a drop parry position, almost behind you while facing your opponent side on. And moving into my favorite part of these videos, the notable practitioner. Of course, this was going to be Obi-Wan because he's the best. And honorable mention to Luminara. Originally, Obi-Wan practiced Form 4, but once he witnessed the demise of his master Qui-Gon Jinn, he chose a more defensive style of lightsaber combat. This allowed him to not only stand up to General Grievous, but to also stand his ground against the chaos of the Battle of Geonosis, as well as standing his ground against the bounty hunter Jango Fett, which I would argue is the best part of Attack of the Clones. While his initial duel with Dooku proved that he was not a master of Soresu yet, by the time of his duel aboard the Invisible Hand, Obi-Wan finally had the mastery to defeat Dooku in lightsaber combat specifically. However, Dooku still had more mastery of the Force, but either way, it was Obi-Wan Kenobi who was able to stand up to Darth Vader and survive, using Soresu against Anakin's Jem'So. And because of Obi-Wan's patience and calm, being the eye of the storm while Anakin raged around him, he was able to move the fight to a destination of his choosing, ending the duel and dismembering Anakin. Wow, this ended on a really dark and disturbing note. That does it for today's lightsaber form video. As I said in the previous video, these are not extensive deep dives, they're just general overviews for people curious about such topics. So next week we will be heading into Form 4, and as always, may the Force be with you. AT-AT is signing off.